was 16 years old, and my dad had been dead 6 years, so everything is so complicated.
Like $5 an hour, that's whatever it was.
No, it was probably like 280.
Wow.
I was grateful for the 280, but I was awkward. I was not confident. I didn't know how to talk to people. I truly think that the thing that I've suffered from the most in my life, as I look at Kobe and, you know, all these pictures of these great people, you know, dude, I just thought too small. I was worried about the 80 bucks. And I was worried about what the car dealers thought about me, that audience. I see these other guys, I see these other people doing things. The greatness is always pulled at my freaking insides so hard, like literally, I'll cry at somebody doing something great because I know it's like, dude, that's you. Mm. I can't catch a ball and I can't knock anybody out, but I know there's something in me that's destined to do something.
I was, you know, I grew up without money and my parents went through some really tough times, and I just wanted a way to have control of my life.
Yeah.
You know, it's like when your parents don't have money, they love me to death, but they couldn't come to games. They couldn't be nurturing. They were worried not to get evicted from the trailer park we lived in, right? When money was no longer an issue, then I had to look internally and work on the things that I was hiding my whole life. It was like a champagne bottle, and I just stuffed all the stuff in it, and like it was waiting to explode. And when money was out of the way and I didn't have to worry about paying the bills or paying the mortgage, I went deep internally, and then I found the things I really love to do. I get to coach Little League, I get to coach baseball, I get to have a nutritionist, I get to eat better, I get to obsess on personal growth, I go to counseling, I go to masterminds like we did this weekend so I can grow as a human. When you're worried about money, you can't do those things, you're just trying to keep up. Don't make money the enemy, because if you have a problem and you can cut a check for that problem, you no longer have that problem.
I don't think I'm the type of person that is brave enough to admit I've made a mistake, honestly, because I think things have not worked out along the way, where things just didn't work out as I had hoped or dreamed them to be. But I don't see them as a mistake, because as quick as you're thinking, oh, poor me, you start to see the light of the door that it's opening that couldn't have opened without it. Mm. Okay. So I don't have like a regret of this was a big mistake or that was a big mistake. But I have to also say I have my whole life been very cognizant of doing anything and exposing myself to anything, even when I didn't want to do it, because I'm deathly afraid of feeling like I would regret. Like, what if I don't do it? That's more of a motivation for me than doing.
Me too.
I learned the same lesson I learned again and again, which is thank God I did it. Mm. Thank God. And the injury of, oh God, you did so poorly, dissipates quickly. But there's an echo to not trying something that's going to sting you, I think. Not that I know that, because I really don't do that, but I'm afraid of it. It's like fear of a nightmare that might happen. I don't know why, because I don't really have that in my life, but I'm fearful of it.